welcome to McAllister Auditorium. At this time, we ask that you please note this facility's emergency exits. Two are located to the sides of the stage, and four are located at the rear of both the main floor and balcony levels. Thank you.
Thank you. The composer of this piece, Leslie Gilreath, would you please stand? Right here. Good evening and welcome to the Spring Symphonic Band Concert here at Furman University. I am really out of breath and pleased to have been able to open this concert with an original composition that was written by a dear friend of mine. He is the director of bands at Somerville High School, and he is the president of the South Carolina Band Directors Association, and also a Furman alum a few years behind me, I think, class of 1990. Awesome. Wonderful composer, arranger, musician, teacher, great guy. So thank you very much, Leslie Gilreath. Good evening. My name is Sue Samuels. For those of us who haven't had the chance yet to meet, I am the director of bands here at Furman, and it is a great pleasure for me to be able to make music with the very talented people who you see seated here on the stage. We rehearse on Mondays and Wednesdays from 4 to 6 p.m., so it's only 4 hours a week in preparation for our concerts this time of year, and I think our students do a really stellar job maintaining great grade point averages and involvement in all aspects of the campus and still making great music. This weekend, we are particularly grateful to be able to welcome the musicians who are participating in the 2024 All-State Bands here of South Carolina. I hope there are many of you high school students sitting in the audience, and we welcome you to our campus, and we're really excited to be with you for the remainder of your rehearsals this weekend and your concert on Sunday afternoon. Somebody tell me, what time is the All-State concert on Sunday? Louder for those of us who can't hear. 4:30? 1:30. 1:30 p.m. So for those of you who are not involved in the All-State weekend, but you like band music, I invite you to come back 1:30 and you'll hear wonderful, talented young musicians who come together just for a weekend and produce a concert. So it's very exciting. The next tune that we're going to play for you is entitled Esprit de Corps by the American composer Robert Jaeger. This one is also kind of fast and furious, but also has some slow, beautiful melodies to contrast as well. And Esprit de Corps, the spirit of camaraderie and fellowship. I really think, in particular, this concert today, which is going to be a concert where we're sharing the music making with friends, several guest conductors that you will hear today, and then the friends who are here in the audience, we wanted to really follow that theme. So the esprit de corps, the spirit of music making, and the joy of coming together to produce something that is better as a group than it is as individuals. I think that that's really special. Tonight is also the last formal concert for our graduating seniors. So these folks will be graduating in May, and this is their last McAllister concert. We will do one more concert in April, but it's going to be much less formal, an outdoors sort of pops concert that we'll do by the lakeside. But for tonight, I would like to honor the 5 senior students from this ensemble, and I'm just gonna call you guys up in score order because I think that way. And I'd like for you to come stand here, and I'd like our Associate Director of Bands, Dr. David Stanley, to help me to make a presentation. So Melinda Thompson, flute. Jace Reddig, oboe. Connor Gregory, trumpet. Emily Holliday, horn. And Henry Niehaus, trombone. And just so that you can get to know them a little bit, I know it says it in the program, but if you guys would just start with Connor and just tell the audience, in fact, we'll do this so you don't have to yell, just tell the audience what your, maybe your hometown and what your major is, and if you know what your plans are after graduation, you can tell them. If you don't know, it's cool too.
Hello, everybody. I am from Spartanburg, and I am a music and earth science major. Oh, earth and environmental science, as it officially is called. And I'm planning on going to graduate school for geology, but I can't say where yet.
My name is Melinda, and I am from Salisbury, North Carolina. I am a biology and music major at Furman, and I plan on going to graduate school for medical illustration.
My name's Jace. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. I'm currently an Asian Studies and Computer Science double major, and after I graduate, I'm planning to teach English in Japan.
My name is Emily Holliday. I'm from Easley, South Carolina. I'm a music education major, and I'm hoping to get a band directing job somewhere in South Carolina following graduation.
My name is Henry Niehaus. I'm from York, South Carolina. I'm a music education major, and I plan to pursue a master's degree in trombone performance.
And we started a tradition just a couple of years ago where we will present each of these students with a commemorative tassel. That's not the official one that they wear when they graduate, but it's a keepsake tassel, and then also a pin that they can wear, a lapel pin from Furman University. And the other part of this that is very special is they have family who will join them on the stage and sit right by them for the next piece. So the family members who are joining them on stage, if you guys would start making your way to the stage, we would appreciate that. I like this tradition because you have supported these students probably since sixth grade band, and you sit out in the audience all the time, and you don't always get to experience the excitement and energy of what happens with the combination of musicians up here on the stage. So parents, friends, loved ones, those of you who are part of our support system, we want you to sit right by your musician and support them here on their last stage performance at McAllister. All right, thank you so much, seniors. This is Esprit de Corps. Thank you so much. It really is a pleasure to have the family up on the stage and to be able to share that moment with you. So thank you for sharing your family with us for the last 4 years. They have been wonderful, loyal, talented, faithful people, and a pleasure to work with. And we will miss them, but we still got a couple more months to go, so we're not saying goodbye yet. I'd like to introduce you to the first guest conductor for the evening. Mr. Alfred Watkins served as director of bands at Lassiter High School in Marietta, Georgia for 30-something years. Forgive me for not remembering, but feel free to check it out in his bio. He was the director of bands at Lassiter when I had my very first teaching job. I graduated from Furman in 1987 at 20 years old and went to serve as the assistant director of bands at Lassiter and worked with Alfred for the next 12 years. And we had a wonderful working relationship that was much more than a working relationship. We were wonderful friends, and we have been wonderful friends ever since. So he is a trusted colleague, a trusted mentor, someone that I have looked up to and tried to model much of what I do on the podium after. So he's an inspiration to me as a person and as a musician. The students in the Allstate bands this weekend got the great opportunity to meet him and get to know him and share in the music making with him. He is the conductor for the 1112 senior band this weekend. So it was really wonderful to be able to just ask him to stick around and do some work with the Furman students. And I love getting to share someone who is so important to me with these people who are also so important to me too. And I think they all instantly knew why. And there was a connection, and they felt it right away as well. So I hope that you will enjoy getting to share in that music making. Alfred, I think I'm going to let you talk about adoration instead of me. Is that cool? I don't want to. I'm talking. They've already heard from me too much. So would you please welcome to the podium wonderful musician, dear friend, Dr. Alfred Watkins.
Thank you so much. Let me change this. I had no intention on addressing you, but since Sue asked, thank you for coming to the concert. Florence Price was born in 1887, died in 1953, died a year before I was born, right, 70 years ago, somewhere in there. She was from Little Rock, Arkansas. Young child prodigy, almost on piano and organ. At the age of four, wrote her first composition at the age of 11. She's from mixed heritage, mulatto, mother and father. Father was a dentist, her mother was a music teacher. She eventually had to leave Little Rock, Arkansas, but at the age of 14, she entered the New England Conservatory of Music. She graduated from New England with a dual degree in composition and organ, when the graduation rate from New England Conservatory was 3%. To give you an idea as to how strong and how sharp she was. And she had a life as a composer. She wrote four symphonies and couldn't get them played. A lot of sonatas, concerti, you name it, because she happened to have been a woman of color. And as she would tell her family and friends, she had double negatives. She was black and she was a woman. Move forward about 2006, 2009. Her music was found in a summer home. And they found boxes and boxes and boxes of music. And so the Chicago Symphony in 2009 played her first symphony that they had played before in 1933, and America had hidden the music of Florence Price. And when they played it again in 2009, it has had a wonderful resurgence many, many years after she's passed away. So this piece is exactly as it speaks. It is an adoration of whatever we choose to adore at the time. It was initially written for the organ and has been transcribed for the modern concert band by Sheldon Williams. We hope you enjoy Florence Price's Adoration.
Thank you. Good evening. My name is David Stanley. I have the privilege of serving as Associate Director of Bands here at Furman. We're so glad you all have joined us tonight. And I'm very pleased to be able to introduce our next guest conductor, who will be leading a John Philip Sousa classic, El Capitan, which you can read about in your program. He is no stranger to this auditorium or this stage, and I also have the distinct privilege of naming him among my most significant mentors and dearest friends. So would you please welcome former director of bands at Furman University, Professor Emeritus, who served here for 26 years with incredible distinction. We're so glad he's here with us again tonight. Please welcome Dr. Les Hicken. If that wasn't enough, we have another guest conductor and a treat for you this evening. Also, a mentor and dear friend of mine who served here as director of athletic bands for about 21, 22 years, 2000, and retired just recently, and previously served as director of bands at Furman University, and before that, graduated from Furman University. He also happens to be the composer of the next piece. And both he and Dr. Hicken are members of the South Carolina Band Directors Association Hall of Fame. Anyone who has ever heard music by this individual, played in his ensembles, or come into contact with him in any sort of music or music education forum is always inspired and lifted up by the power of what our activity can do. Would you please join me in welcoming to the stage Mr. Jay Bocook.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We have one more very short selection that I think you will really enjoy. And before we bring out the guest artist for that, I want to just make sure that I say thank you to each and every one of you for spending about an hour or so of your lives with us here this evening. Thank you so much for being here and sharing in the wonderful music making. We titled this concert Music with Friends because of the guest conductors and guest artists who are so involved, and because we truly feel that when we work together and share in the music making, that it does spread friendship and joy and positivity out there in the world. I think that's a really important thing to do. So it's a really important part of our lives, and we can't just do it in the practice room by ourselves. So sharing it with the audience is part of that kindred spirit of music making. So thank you for being here. And we're going to move on to our final selection here, which is Leroy Anderson's Bugler's Holiday. We have some wonderful trumpet soloists that are featured for you. If you do not know this tune, you will walk away singing it. If you do know it, you will walk away singing it. It's one of those that is just going to stay with you, and I really think you're going to enjoy this. So once again, thank you for being here. Thank you to the terrific students for their music making. And I would ask you to please welcome to the stage trumpet soloists Buddy Deschler, Craig King, and Thomas Cotter, and Dr. David Stanley to conduct Bugler's Holiday.